Good morning, students of senior 2. This is Sir Mushal here. So this basically is your first class, which had to be online due to the COVID reasons. Okay, so this basically this chapter that we are basically starting, okay, this is your first chapter in your syllabus, and we are basically picking up from where we left in the last year. If you remember, we did till section 3 till Yahya Khan. Now after that, we have started from chapter 13, which is why did East Pakistan seek and then form independent state of Bangladesh. So we know all the turmoil that was happening in Pakistan, which included both East and West Pakistan. Now during this time, there was some serious trouble that was boiling up between East and West Pakistan, which eventually led to the creation of Bangladesh. Now what happened? Okay, we're gonna talk about the background, the events that actually led to or eventually led to the creation of Bangladesh. Now if you talk about the background, now we know when Maulana Fazlul Haq, when he was declaring or presenting a Pakistan resolution in 1914 Lahore, he basically stated certain regions in India which were to be made into a separate nation. Now that among other areas also included Assam and Bengal. So eventually when Pakistan was created in 1947, it was basically made in a way that there was East Pakistan and there was West Pakistan, and in between there would be a whole country, a different whole country, which actually was India. All right, now the Bengalis were initially upset about it. Why? Because they felt that first of all, Bengal again had to be partitioned. It was previously partitioned in 1905. It eventually was partitioned again in 1947. Okay, and certain parts of it were, you know, given to India. Now the most important city or port, which was Kolkata, that was given to India as well. So they actually felt that, you know, they were given a bad deal here. Also, you know, there was no other country in the world which was separated geographically. It was many political analysts say it was practically impossible to rule a country which was divided by hundreds of miles, and in between, and it was basically both the regions were sandwiched between the arch rival, which was India, and whose main agenda was to, you know, rectify, according to them, the mistake which was Pakistan. So they basically were trying day in day and night to, you know, make Pakistan suffer. So political analysts say it was very difficult for Pakistan, for East and West Pakistan to have survived for a long period of time just because of the geographical problems. Even after, but it wasn't just geographical problems. If you look at it, you know, there were certain other problems as well. First of all, there was social and cultural disparity. Okay, so basically what is social and cultural disparity? What basically meant is that East and West Pakistan, West Pakistan being the current Pakistan and East Pakistan being now Bangladesh, they were socially very different from one another. First of all, their language was basically different. West Pakistan had different regions. There was Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, and there was a single unifying language, which was basically Urdu. In East Pakistan, there was Bengal. Now, when Qaid-e-Azam named Urdu as the national language of Pakistan, the Bengalis took great offense to it, and they basically got out on the streets, and they basically said, you know, Bengali as it is spoken by the majority of the people, almost 56% of the entire population of Pakistan, it should be made as a national language of Pakistan. Qaid-e-Azam, however, remained adamant that although Urdu is not spoken by many people, it was only spoken by about 6% population of Pakistan, but it was nonetheless the unifying force of Pakistan, because everyone could speak it. So therefore, it should be named. It should be the national language of Pakistan. But Bengalis never accepted that. But eventually this was solved in 1956 constitution, where Bengali was recognized as one of the official languages of Pakistan. But if you talk about other things, you know, cultural things, you know, the festivals were different, the dresses, the attires were different. The Bengalis had a different attire, whereas the West Pakistan used to wear shalwar kameez, you know. Also the folk stories, the literature, the heroes were all different. So there was, a completely different culture between the two, East and West Pakistan. So that caused a problem as well. Now, another one was basically economic disparity. What do we mean by economic disparity? Basically, that meant that during the years when East and West Pakistan were together, East Pakistan was economically worse off as compared to West Pakistan. Now, when Pakistan was basically, Pakistan got its independence, Pakistan was a poor country. Okay, but as the years progressed, it eventually developed and it eventually got better. However, East Pakistan complained that they were not growing at the pace that West Pakistan was growing. For example, between 49 and 60, the income per capita increased in West Pakistan from 330 to 373 rupees, whereas in East Pakistan it dropped from 305 to 288 rupees. They basically complained that the biggest export of Pakistan was jute, which was basically made in Bangladesh at that point of time. However, they claimed that all the money that was generated from the export of jute was taken to West Pakistan to be spent there. So, you know, the money that should be spent on East Pakistan was not being spent on them. Okay, and apart from that, you know, like schools, hospitals, they were not being built in Pakistan. In fact, between 47 till 48, the number of primary schools in Pakistan, West Pakistan, rose by 163%, but in East Pakistan, the increase was just 38%. Okay, so this basically shows that, you know, East Pakistan was not that wealthy as compared to West Pakistan, and this caused a strain between the relations of East and West Pakistan. Now, finally, let's just end it over here. Okay, we're gonna talk about the rest of the problems in the next class. Now, up till now, I hope you have understood each and everything that I was trying to tell you. If you haven't, you can always contact me. I'll be more than happy to clear out any confusion that you have. All right, this is it from my side. You guys take care of yourself. Hopefully we'll be seeing each other soon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.